The Cabzeus from GFI Systems is something that I should have demonstrated a long time ago, and I apologise to Henry and the guys at GFI Systems. This is a brilliant piece of hardware, and I'm going to say that unabashedly, unreservedly. It is a ripper. We've got an analog-digital hybrid guitar cabinet simulator. It doesn't just do guitar cabs, though. It does bass cabs, does telephones. About 43 sims are in there at the moment in the current firmware, which is version 3. On the front panel, you will see two discrete inputs, left and right. You can run them in mono if you want. Today I'm running via this little Moore 008, which is basically a Boogie Mark III preamp sim, just to give it a bit of ampness. If you wanted to, you could run an acoustic guitar into the left-hand channel and use a full-range speaker for it on the output. So you could actually have two discrete inputs, two discrete outputs, and you can do that with bass because there are bass speakers in there as well. Today, though, I am running through the mono left input. It is coming out stereo straight into my MBox 3 Pro and into Logic. On the top of the Cabzeus, you'll see three knobs, two brown ones. Each of those is the mic placement knob for left and right, respectively, so that each discrete channel you can swap your mic from the edge of the speaker through to the center of the speaker. The middle knob is to change the presets from 1 to 8. So if I wanted to change my speaker sound to be more on the edge of the speaker, I roll it off to the edge, hit the middle knob. Want a bit more treble, a bit more presence, I'd roll it into the center and then click it again. The idea about clicking this middle knob is so you can lock those positions. You'll see a couple of pad switches here, minus 20, minus 30 dB. They are for people who want to run a guitar amp, power amp out into the Cabzeus, and then they would use the pass-through to continue the speaker line back into their speaker cabinet, which means they can feed the front of house desk a nice guitar cab simulation and have all of the roaring power of their cabinet on stage. It has a headphone output with its own level control. It has MIDI control, so you can remotely control any one of the 8 presets that you can load into this. It has USB, so you can update the firmware or save your presets to the computer, as I have been doing. It ships with some software called CabsLab, which we are now going to have a look at because it tells us more about what the Cabzeus can actually do. And you'll see me flick between the clean and dirty channels of this Moore 008. Playing around with this excellent CabsLab software. It's the interface basically that drives the Cabzeus, and it's something that you'll probably be looking at a lot if you're working in a studio environment or even just programming your Cabzeus to go out on the road, you know, to use it on your pedalboard or in a desk situation or whatever. It's very cool. It's divided into three parts: the dashboard, the tone chart, which gives you kind of a visual representation of all of the frequency spectrums of all of the different speaker emulations, like so. And then a built-in user guide, which is also very handy because it's quite a deep unit, the Cabzeus, and if you get stuck on stuff that you're not quite sure of, you can access the user guide at any time. It also lets you access the presets, and I've just written half a dozen there just for fun, and it also lets you load or read presets from the actual hardware itself. So, for instance, if I want to read preset number 1 from the hardware... There it is, preset number 3, read. Preset number 8. if I want to load one of my presets into the hardware, I can then just hit right, and it corresponds with the hardware, and now preset 8 will have Berg BT, which is the British Type 2 12-inch speaker. Dashboard. Back to the dashboard. You've got your left speaker type and your right speaker type. If you want to solo it, they can have a better listen and, you know, fix up your mic placement. You've got sealed, open. You can pick any one of your speaker types, and then you can go and do the same thing to your left speaker. So I might want an American Type 3, for instance. And then I can alternate, click solo again. And as well, I can delay one of those speakers if I want to. So here I'm delaying my British 12-inch by 62 milliseconds. Which gives it that kind of airy feeling. Also, I can turn up or down. I can blend the left or the right speaker here. I can invert the phase just by going backwards. And that's for both of them. Fabulous. In the stereo mics part of the dashboard, I've got access to the close mic, the room mic, and the blending controls for both. And this accesses just one of the speakers, so at the moment it's accessing the American Type 2. Let's say go to the British Type 1. So I can blend. My microphone, I can also alter the reverb types. The warmer it gets, and then I can alter the... and blend the close mic in with the room mic. And turn them up or down. Pretty cool, huh? As I said before, I can access my own presets anytime. If I want to write over that or write another preset, it's as simple as picking the speaker that I want. And then hitting the plus sign to add your preset, writing the name of it in here, Berg BT412 or something like that, and hitting save, and then it's going to be in the preset menu next time I want to use it. There's all of the miscellaneous stuff as well. You know, if you want to turn your guitar into a sort of a telephone, you can do that. Megaphone. Gears is an interesting one because there are speaker emulations of other products like the Palmer, Normal and Bright. Five twin. But it sure sounds cool. We've got the Crimson Box, which I'm guessing is the old Hughes and Kettner. And Cabzilla for a bright or punchy. So that's it. That's CabsLab. It's running 105 at the moment, version 105, with the version 3 firmware in the Cabzeus. The Cabzeus, I have to say, Henry and his team, it's one of the most brilliant small speaker emulations I've ever come across. Easy to use after you get your head around it for an hour or two. It took me a little bit, but I'm glad I did spend the time because it's very cool. See ya.